Good day, everyone. The topic that we will discuss for today is all about collaborative learning. I am Dimple and San Agustin together with Isaiah Anyo and Wynonah Rosa Jose, and we are the presenters. First, let's define collaborative learning. Collaborative learning is an educational approach to teaching and learning that involves group of learners working together to solve a problem, complete a task, or create a product. The term collaborative learning refers to an instruction method in which the learners at various performance levels work together in small groups toward a common goal. There are many approaches to collaborative learning. First is, learning is an active process whereby learners assimilate the information and relate this new knowledge to a framework of prior knowledge. The active learning is generally defined as any instructional method that engages students in the learning process. In short, active learning requires students to do meaningful learning activities and think about what they are doing. And also, yung mga bagong information that the learners gathered is related to a framework of prior knowledge. Next is, learning requires a challenge that opens the door for the learner to actively engage his or her peers and to process and synthesize information rather than simply memorize and regurgitate it. This approach actively engages learners to process and synthesize information and concepts rather than using rote memorization of facts and figures. Next is, learners benefit when exposed to diverse viewpoints from people with varied backgrounds. When students work together as a group, they can practice their skills and share their knowledge to others. Through socialization, nakakakuha po tayo ng mga new information galing sa iba't ibang pananaw ng ibang tao na nakakausap natin or nakakasalamuha natin. Next is, learning flourish in a social environment where conversation between learners take place. Mas umuunlad yung kaalaman ng isang bata kung nakikipag-usap sila sa kapwa nilang estudyante. Dahil at their age, they have different knowledge and perspective or on the different viewpoints. Last approach is, in the collaborative learning environment, the learners are challenged both socially and emotionally as they listen to different perspectives and are required to articulate and defend their ideas. So in so doing, the learners begin to create their own unique conceptual framework and not rely solely on text framework. So in collaborative learning setting, yung mga learners is mayroon po silang opportunity to converse with other people and also they have an opportunity to present and defend their own ideas, exchange diverse beliefs, questions other, and be actively engaged not only in the classroom but also in the environment.
Next is the elements of collaborative learning. A learning exercise only qualifies as collaborative learning to the extent that the following elements are present.
Number one is positive interdependence. Team members are obliged to rely on one another to achieve the goal. If any team members fail to do their part, everyone suffers consequences. Members need to believe that they are linked with others in a way that ensures that they all succeed together. Positive interdependence is the belief by each individual that there is value in working with other members and that both individual learning and work products will be better as a result of collaboration.
Number two is considerable interaction. Members help and encourage each other to learn. They do this by explaining what they understand and by gathering and sharing knowledge. Group members must be done interactively providing one another with feedback, challenging one another's conclusions and reasoning, and perhaps most importantly, teaching and encouraging one another. Next one is individual accountability and personal responsibility. All members in a group are held accountable for doing their share of the work, and for mastery of all of the material to be learned. Next is social skills. Members are encouraged and helped to develop and practice trust building, leadership, decision making, communication, and conflict management skills. Last one is group self-evaluating. Team members set group goals, periodically assess what they are doing well as a team, and identify changes they will make to function more effectively in the future.
Now, let's talk about the benefits of collaborative learning. First, develop higher-level thinking skills. The higher-order thinking skills can help one individual to solve problems efficiently by anticipating connection between different ideas. Next, build self-esteem in students. Collaborative learning has been shown not only to develop higher-level thinking skills in students, but boost their confidence and self-esteem. Katulad po ng mga group projects na namamaximize nito yung educational experience ng student by demonstrating the materials while improving social and interpersonal skills. Next, develop oral communication skills. And also, it develops oral communication skills. As a teacher, we must plan collaborative activities for the learners, like group activities, because it also helps students to sharpen both oral and written communication. Isa pa pong example is yung group work, like projects. It helps to strengthen verbal communication skills of the student. When a group of students work on a project or activity together, nagkakaroon po sila ng connection sa isa't isa through communication. And sometimes, may mga student na mahihiyain or nahihirapan silang humarap o magsalita sa harap ng madaming tao. In group projects or activity, isa siyang way to boost their confidence. The student will easier to practice their communication skills in a small group setting compared to a whole class setting.
It also develops social interaction skills. In the result of our research, it showed that students prefer to work in groups rather than individually. Therefore, collaborative learning shows a significant effect on students' social interaction skills. Students believe that collaborative learning encourages everyone to work best with others and enhances socialization among members. Also, collaborative learning processes create environments where students can practice building leadership skills. When individuals are tasked with working together to achieve a common goal, they are being given the opportunity to develop high-level skills. While having to organize, assign, and teach, they are learning how to manage both themselves and others while leading in a productive fashion. It also establishes an atmosphere of cooperation and helping school-wide. A collaborative or cooperative learning approach involves students working together on activities or learning tasks in a group small enough to ensure that everyone participates. Students in a group may work on separate tasks contributing to a common overall outcome or work together on a shared task. This is distinct from unstructured group work.
Students develop responsibility for each other. Build more positive heterogeneous relationships. Create an environment of active, involved, exploratory learning. For collaborative learning strategies. Number 1. Think, pair, share. The instructor possesses a question, preferable one demanding analysis, evaluation, or synthesis, and give students about a minute to think through an appropriate response. This think time can be spent writing also. Students then turn to a partner and share their response. And during the third step, student response can be shared with four-person learning team, with a large group or with the entire class during follow-up discussion. The caliber of discussion is enhanced by these techniques, and all students have an opportunity to learn by reflections and verbalization. Number 2, 3-step interview. Common as an icebreaker or a team building exercise, this structure can also be used to share information such as hypothesis or reaction to a film or article. Number 1, student from dyads. One student interview the others. Student switch role. Number 3 is the dyad link with a second dyad. This 4-member learning team then discuss the information or insight gleaned from the initial paired interviews. Number 3. Numbered herds together. Member of learner teams usually composed of 4 individuals, count of 1, 2, 3, or 4. The instructor possesses a question, usually factual in nature, but requiring some higher order thinking skills. Students discuss the question, making certain that every group member know that agreed upon the answer. Number 4. Simple jigsaw. The faculty member divides an assignment or topic into 4 parts with all students from each learning team volunteering to become experts on one of the parts. Expert team then work together to master their part of the material and also to discover the best way to help others learn it. All experts then assemble in their home learning teams where they teach the other group member.